One thing I'd like to see from E22 from Pit is that the use of his arrows. I think it should be pretty good.
It's definitely good when in the advantage state. When you're pushing the cloud state off the so, let's see how Flawless. Not going for moves much, more or less going for kind of playing with shielding and trying to beat any punishes. There's some way when there's camping. So, obviously, Flawless is one to camp when it breaks. Each one keeps doing a good job of punishing all his approaches.
So, he's going to be playing very patiently, waiting for his opponent to come to him.
Yeah, that's exactly how he's playing.
Which would be a pretty smart target against a cloud player.
See if always tries to go for the hard reads, because a hard read cross line, you guys off stage. That thing will punch through the air, it'll just like do smash attacks. Chip does not have really good kill options. So his opponents tend to live to very high percents.
By far on stage, I think one of those pits. Oh, there we go.
Nope.
Oh, see? And he has one too. So
that's one of the strongest characters.
Yeah, from what I do know from Pit is that his forward tilt is one of the he's a strong move, and the back side of his down smash also looks pretty cool.
Yeah. He also likes catching opponents with up smash, like in landings.
Mm-hmm.
Pretty long, lasting hit box, comes out fast, like really fast, actually, it's like frame six or something.
Yeah.
So you don't want to land up a Pit at all. And the neutral really gives a lot of dash grabs, dash attacks, and just patience. It's a lot of patience.
Because like, when it comes to Pit, he's really good with racking up damage. There's lots of moves that are multi-hit and all that. But when it comes to the kill, that's where a Pit may have struggle.
He's really he's just really like solidly like decent character. Okay. He doesn't have anything really great to do with.
So it's like, there's nothing bad about him, but at the same time, there's nothing that's good about him. But yeah, there are the fact that you can rack damage, but that kill is really sort of unhealthy.
Yeah, we got Wallace with Limit Break. A Rage Cloud with Limit Break is going to be very scary to play around. So, if Wallace does like a nasty bowling dance, cross slash, we're falling under the finishing touch that can easily steal the stock right now. I wanted to see it coming. I don't like these empty hops. He's not getting anything off of it except for being punished. Falling up there? Nope.
I think I could have followed up another up air.
This is essentially the
punish. That's what it is. I was going to mention that. It's the one thing that E22 is doing is that he's doing very unsafe side Bs.
I like that. I like that. E22's got macro for the side Bs too, so you can do that.
Because that's how he took off his first and his second top. Stop.
Right. I'm getting off commentary now.
Alright, man. Hello? Hey, how's it going, man?
Good.
That was a pretty good first game I saw there.
Yeah.
I know, before I start talking about you, let's just keep an eye on this match. So we see E22 going on to Mario, a more consistent character. I think he realized that when it comes to playing Pit against Cloud, there's not many kill options.
Definitely. I've definitely seen like Pit's a lot more on these characters in this game. Like compared like some characters like heavyweights, you know, like early kills and characters like Bayonetta. Pit's a really honest character. Like. He kills at like a decent percent, but he's never too early. Cloud's got amazing kill power. No, I didn't see game one. Who won?
Flawless actually won game one.
Okay.
He read the side B on safe, which is really on safe, and I think that's the reason why he switched to Mario. But he was able to read it and got the kill off of it.
Oh,
here we go with the cave. E22 making a nice, fresh swish right there.
So E22's got a decent lead here.
Because the one thing that I see now with E22 is that I think that when it comes to Mario and Cloud, he has the cape, and it's really easy to get Cloud at early percents.
Not to mention, Cloud really is just good combo for Mario, and he's showing that, like, he's getting all those grabs up those up tilts, and just really dragging him across the platforms.
But I do believe that Flawless has, like, at the same time he's playing Cloud, someone who has really good kill options, can back up the game, make his up airs are really good if he does just play them up properly.
Yeah. So I think, here? Okay. He waited on the limit that time. That was good for him. Because I think if he used it like he did last time, he would have been caped, the game would have been over.
But the one thing I see that Ron Flawless is that he's playing very aggressively. He just wants that kill, but he needs to play smart because he thought E22 guys been told before. Oh, there we go. That was very smart.
Overextended and got caught. His ups, he got beaten out by Cloud's down air. Very few moves to beat Cloud's down air, so. But I mean, Flawless has it.
Flawless still has a chance. Cloud and back throw. Yeah, there we go. E22 taking that second game. So see what falls in the band, because the stage was pretty good for E22.
Yeah, though triplats usually are pretty good for Cloud too. So I don't know. Yeah, I don't think he played. I haven't seen what other characters he plays, so I don't know.
As of I know, Flawless won't be switching anytime soon because he's trying to keep consistent with his Cloud of his. But taking it to Battlefield, pretty fun stage for him, I guess.
Yeah. I mean, I think it's interesting that he took Battlefield, considering, like, the Triplets in the previous game really hurt him a lot. He just got jumbled around. I thought he would have taken a, like, S or Town and City. All of the up air strings just starting out. That's probably like the one good thing that Cloud has on the stage. He's really good at juggling the platforms with this up air. Like, above everything else, like, that's probably one of the biggest reasons.
But E22 very playing, you know, camping out the fireballs and playing very patiently. It's gonna reward him a lot when Flawless comes in recklessly. It's one thing he's doing, he's playing very aggressively.
Yeah, he's trying to counter his patience with offense, which isn't. It's not working out too well. I mean, I think what I want to see from Flawless is that if he stops playing so aggressively, when he doesn't have limit, he can, like, charge limit going. If he has to use it, then he can just back out and turn it again. But right now, he's
good. Right now, if Flawless plays his card properly, he can get that kill. Oh, there we go.
I don't even know if it would have killed from. Oh, actually, next one.
Oh, there we go.
Trunk back here.
Pretty good thing. E22 keeping that consistency up. He's stringing up the combos on the stage. He's probably happy about picking Battlefield because he's like, you know, I can probably string up anything I want on this.
Honestly, he's probably just thinking, same stage, just slightly longer to kill. Honestly, Flawless is just playing like, he keeps hitting him like unsafely on shield. And he's getting like grabbed and just comboed off of it. Like, I can't really say much about the combo part, like, DIing out of the combo part, Cloud is a bad call, especially with limit. But, as for, like, the aggressive part, he definitely can fix.
Right now, it's staying on that top platform against Mario, not a smart option. He needs to get off that, he needs to stay off those platforms to get out of the center stage.
I think he might, he's can die near the limit from cross flash, but, like, from center stage, I'm not sure.
Oh, and Alex Yuko right there.
Yeah.
So, if he gets that, the limit, and he's at rage right now, pretty scary against the Cloud.
He's playing really aggressive now. He's just throwing out more hitboxes.
Oh, and there we go with that up smash, but it's about here.
Next one's chicken. Even if it's a little stale, he has to.
Oh, there we go.
Okay.
Oh, there we go.
I wonder if you try to like drop down and like jump down. Oh, and it was like a bad drop. Mario. And I think I got a play again.